Last time we learned the common name system of alkynes. So some example of common name system of alkynes remain. So today we continue that common name system of alkyne. So see here, common name system . So I already told you that alkynes, they are called as a derivative of acetylene. When you decide the common name of alkynes, then acetylene act as a parent. So first, today's first example, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2C, triple bond CH. So this is an example. So this is a parent part, that is acetylene part. One of the hydrogen of acetylene get replaced by this alkyl group. As this alkyl group contain carbon 4, therefore from carbon 3 and more than 3 when present in alkyl group, then we must write down the prefix N, iso, neo, secondary, tertiary before the name of alkyl group. Here, as all carbon they are straight, 4 carbon present. When you are straight carbon, you should keep the prefix N before the name of alkyl group. Therefore, its name N-butyl. And for this parent, I mention name acetylene. So, its name N-butyl acetylene. Then, we turn towards second example, CH3, CH3, C, triple bond CH. This is acetylene part, therefore I mention in bracket. Whatever remaining part, that is the hydrogen atom of acetylene replaced by this alkyl group. So to this main parent part, this carbon is attached, and this carbon attached to other two carbon, therefore it is secondary carbon. In this alkyl group, 3 carbon present, therefore it is called as secondary propyl. So this is secondary propyl, and for this purpose I mention the word for parent acetylene. So its name secondary propyl acetylene. Then third one, CH3, CH, CH3, CH2C, triple bond CH. So this is a parent part. One of the hydrogen atom of acetylene replaced by this alkyl group. Then we focus on this alkyl group. So this alkyl group contain 4 carbon. Therefore, this alkyl group is butyl. But we must use the prefix. As here carbon second contain 1 methyl group. Therefore, we mention the prefix iso. Therefore, its common name isobutyl acetylene. So isobutyl acetylene. Then we turn towards next one example. Next one, CH3C, 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 triple bond C. CH3, CH3, CH3. So this is a parent acetylene skeleton. So two hydrogen atom present in acetylene replaced by two same alkyl group. Then we focus on alkyl group. So alkyl group attached to parent part, and this carbon attached to other 3 carbon. Therefore, this carbon is tertiary. Total number of carbon 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, butyl. So this is a tertiary butyl. This is also tertiary butyl. Tertiary butyl present 2 times, therefore mention di tertiary butyl acetylene. So its name di tertiary butyl acetylene. Then I turn towards next one, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2C, triple bond C, CH3. Again here acetylene's 2 hydrogen replaced by alkyl group, but that 2 alkyl group they are differ. This is a methyl group. This is a 4 carbon and straight chain, therefore this is a N-butyl. ब्यूटाइल बी कम फर्स्ट देन मिथाइल सी एम, अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर. सो अल्फाबेटिकली एन ब्यूटिल फर्स्ट देन मिथिल एंड फॉर दिस पर्पज मेंशन द नेम एसिटिलीन. सो इट्स नेम एन ब्यूटिल मिथिल एसिटिलीन. देन फोकस ऑन नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल. नेक्स्ट एग्जाम्पल CH3, CH2, CH, CH3C, triple bond C, CH2, CH3. So this is a parent part. Right side ethyl group presents. Left side 1, 2, 3, 4 butyl group present. But butyls, this carbon attached to that parent skeleton, this carbon attached to directly other two carbon, therefore this is secondary carbon, this is secondary butyl. Butyl come first then ethyl, then I mention the ethyl, and for this parent part I use the word acetylene or suffix acetylene. So common name secondary butyl ethyl acetylene. So this is about a common name system of alkynes. Again I remind you, all alkynes, they are obtained from acetylene. Acetylene is the parent of all alkynes in common name system. We can remove one hydrogen or both hydrogen atom of acetylene by same or different alkyl group. Firstly, write down name of alkyl group, later on keep the suffix acetylene. But when in your alkyl group carbon 3 and more than 3 present, then before the name of such alkyl group you should keep the prefix N iso secondary tertiary neo to indicate the carbon skeleton of alkyl group, and then you keep the name of alkyl group, and lastly keep the word acetylene. This is one. Second important thing, when two same alkyl group attached to either side of that acetylene, then use the prefix di, because two alkyl group they are same, so its name dialkyl acetylene. But in your alkyl group, if carbon 3 and more than 3 present, then naturally you should use the prefix. If two different alkyl group present around the acetylene, they arrange such an alkyl group according to alphabetic order and keep then suffix acetylene. So here I mention N-butyl methyl acetylene. Here I mention secondary butyl ethyl acetylene. So like this, you should mention the common name system of alkynes. Later on, we discuss IUPAC system of alkynes. I think there is no doubt in common name system. So, we take next one system that is called as IUPAC system. So, this IUPAC name, how to write down name of that organic compound according to IUPAC system? That you already learn detail in basic principle and techniques topic. So today I take some example of IUPAC system. Of alkynes. So rules you already learn. I take example. CH3CH2C. Triple bond CH. Second, CH triple bond CH. So for first these two alkynes here in second and the third one example, I mentioned third one CH3C triple bond CH. These two examples are important because in these two examples there is no need to keep the position of alkynes before the suffix yne. So you already learn how to write down the name of IUPAC name of alkynes. Again I remind, count the total number of carbon present in this structure. So here in example 2 there is only 2 carbon present, 2 carbon alkane ethane, ethane's ane replaced by yne, so its name ethyne, so ethyne. Similar manner I keep the name of third example, 1 2 3 carbon propane, propane's ane replaced by yne, so it is called as a propyne. Okay, but from carbon 4 and more than 4 there is a isomerism start, therefore from carbon 4 and more than 4 you should keep the position of triple bond before the suffix yne. So from carbon 4 you have to write down the numbering that start from that end which gives less number to triply bonded carbon. This is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this one 4. So one position for triple bond carbon. 4 carbon is butane, so I keep BUT, position of triple bond 1, suffix yne, so its name but1yne. Then I keep some another example for this purpose. Next example is CH3CH, CH3C, triple bond C, CH2CH3. So in this case if we start numbering from right side 1 2 3, left side 1 2 3, so from both side triply bonded carbon, they are equidistant. But remember here there is a branching present that is called as alkyl substituent. If your triply bonded carbon is equidistant from both side, then you have to write down numbering from that side which gives less number to alkyl group. Again I remind, your first preference, less number goes to carbon carbon triple bond. If carbon carbon triple bond have same number from both side, then our next target, if alkyl group present, then less number goes to alkyl group. Therefore I start numbering from left to right, 1 2 3 4 5 and 6. Firstly write down name of alkyl group with its position. It's 2-methyl, then hex 3-yne, so its name 2-methyl hex 3-yne. The next one CH3CH CH3C, triple bond C, CH2 CH CH3 CH3. So I will write down numbering from left to right, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So alkyl group position 2 and 6, same alkyl group present, therefore keep the position 2 comma 6, same 2 time, therefore di, which alkyl group, that is methyl, so its name 2,6-dimethyl, 7 carbon HEPT, hept. Before yne keep position, position is 3 3 yne, so its name 2,6-dimethyl hept 3 yne. So this is another example of alkynes to decide its IUPAC name. Then again I take next example of alkynes. So next example of alkynes is this one. So see here, from this side triply bond position 1 2 3, from this side 1 2 3 4, therefore numbering start from this one, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Alkyl group position on 2-methyl present, on 6 again 2-methyl group present, therefore name 2, 6, 6 trimethyl, then 7 carbon HEPT, triple bond position 3, therefore its name 2,6,6 trimethyl hept 3-yne. Okay, this is an easy one. Then we have to go for next one. So next one, so see here, numbering this side 1, 2, 3, 4, from this side 1, 2, 3. So I start numbering from this one, less number to triply bonded carbon. 5, 6, look here, 6, 7, 7, here 7, 8, therefore longest chain 7, 8. So alkyl group 2, again 2, again 6, again 6. So same alkyl group present 4 times, therefore we keep its position 2, 2, 6, 6, total 4 times tetra, which alkyl group? Methyl. So its name 2,2,6,6 tetramethyl, then 8 carbon with position number 3 for triple bond, 8 means oct, 3-yne. So its name 2,2,6,6 tetramethyl oct 3-yne. So another example. Then we go for next one. Next one. So look here, when look this example, numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, alkyl group position on 2 methyl present, on 6 this one ethyl present, on 7 methyl present, okay. So in this example, 2 different alkyl groups present. You should write down the name of alkyl group firstly, that one which come alphabetically first. So ethyl come first, therefore we keep the position 6 ethyl. Later on methyl position on 2, then 7 on 7. Total 3, therefore tri. Alkyl group name methyl. Total number of carbon atom present in parent chain 8. Oct. Then position 3. YNE. So name 6 ethyl 2,7,7 trimethyl oct 3 YNE. So this is another example of IUPAC system of alkynes. Then here take next one. So look here. From this side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 position for triple bond. So here remember 1, 2, 3, 4, numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Alkyl group. Look here, carbon 2 methyl, carbon 2 methyl, carbon 6 methyl, carbon 6 methyl, carbon 7 methyl, carbon 7 ethyl. So here methyl and ethyl group present, we must write down ethyl group first, position 7. So name 7 ethyl, then keep the position of methyl group 2, 2, 6, 6, 7, total methyl group 5 time, pentamethyl, pentamethyl non 4 yne. Okay, 7 ethyl 2 2 6 6 7 pentamethyl non 4 yne. So this is IUPAC name of this substance. Then then we do another thing, that we should draw the structure of substance by giving the IUPAC name. So IUPAC name, look here, 3-3-dimethyl pent 1-yne. So this is IUPAC name of that substance. We have to draw the structure. Firstly, you concentrate on parent. Parent contain 5 carbon and triple bond in between carbon 1 and 2. So you have to keep the 5 carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is a 5 carbon. Keep carbon number 1, this one or this one. Suppose this is carbon number 1, there is a triple bond. Here we observe triple bond in between 1 and 2. Then on carbon number 3, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Carbon number 3, there is a 2 methyl group. So this is 2 methyl group. So this structure 3-3-dimethyl pent 1-yne. So like this, you have to draw structure when they gives us the IUPAC name of substance. Then the next one, they provide common name and we have to draw the structure and keep its IUPAC name. For example, dineopentylacetylene. So this example is a dineopentylacetylene. You have to draw a structure. Acetylene means carbon carbon triple bond. Okay, so you have to draw neopentyl two times because di present. So here right side and left side neopentyl group present. So here CH2C CH3 CH3 CH3, this is neopentyl. This side also CH2, here C CH3 CH3 CH3, this is neopentyl. So this is a dineopentylacetylene. This is the structure for that purpose. Then we keep the IUPAC name of this one. What is the question? That draw the structure and write down IUPAC name. So they provide us common name. So this is common name. According to common name system, we draw the structure. Then we keep its IUPAC name. As alkyl group present on both sides, they are same. You should start numbering from any end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So 8 carbon is longest one. On carbon 2, 2 methyl group. Carbon 7, 2 methyl group. Therefore, its name 2, 2, 4, 4, total 4. Tetramethyl, 4 methyl group present. Oct, then 4-yne. So its name 2-2-4-4 tetramethyl oct 4-yne. This is all about that common name. We have to draw structure and keep its IUPAC name. Then we turn towards next one. That next one is a different one. That is N-butyl. Then isopropyl acetylene. In this common name system, they use two different alkyl groups around present around acetylene. So this is acetylene skeleton. So right side or left side, you can keep any isopropyl and N-butyl. Suppose the isopropyl group CH3CH CH3, this is isopropyl. N-butyl, 4 times straight chain CH3CH2CH2CH2C. Okay. So this is structure N-butyl isopropyl acetylene. So this is the parent one. Then you apply the IUPAC rule to decide its name, IUPAC name. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So on carbon 2 there is a methyl group, 2 methyl, then 8 carbon oct, 3 YNE. So its name 2 methyl oct 3 YNE. So this is about IUPAC system of alkynes. So student, today we discuss more detail about the remaining common name system and IUPAC system for alkynes. I think you understand that IUPAC same system particularly. So in next period we discuss the important part, that is preparation and isomerism of alkynes. Thank you.